A bomb is projected with a velocity 1414 meter per second at an angle of 45 degree with the horizontal. If it explodes into two equal pieces at the highest point, calculate the time after which center of mass of the two pieces strikes the ground, G10. Here bomb is projected with 1414 at 45 degree and explosion takes place exactly at the highest point. So here the explosion is taking place. So because of this explosion, the produced two pieces may fall or may move with different velocities or same velocity depending on their masses. Since the two pieces are equal, if I imagine one piece falls freely, then other piece continues to move. Suppose if I take one piece falls freely, the other one moves like this and hits the ground at somewhere. Or even one piece may retrace its path, it may come back and then other piece continues to move, here it may hit. So whatever the case might be, once explosion takes place, different pieces may move along different paths. Since explosion is an internal phenomena and internal force cannot cause any change in the state of mass, the center of mass continues to move along the original parabolic path. It continues to move along this path only. If I say one piece falls here, first piece, second piece falls here, but center of mass position is this one only. Even if I say one piece is here, comes back and strikes, second piece is here, the center of mass position same. Center of mass moves as if there is no change. It continues to move along this path only. Therefore, the time of travel or time of flight is 2u sin theta by g. So it is 2 into 1414 sin 45 1 by root 2 by 10. So it is 2 into 1000 root 2 1414 means by 10 into root 2. So if I cancel root 2 on numerator and denominator, 0 and 0 gets cancelled, so 200s. That means from the point of projection to this point, it is 200 seconds. But from the highest point, that is only descending time, it is only 100 seconds. So in 100 seconds, the center of mass strikes the ground. So irrespective of the explosion, velocities gained by the two pieces, center of mass continues to move along the same path and strikes the ground. So this is our time of descent, this is time of ascent, this is time of descent. The time of descent is half the time of flight, since time of flight is 200 seconds and descent becomes 100 seconds. So after 100 seconds, the center of mass of the two pieces will strike the ground.